Hi, this is Brandon from Watches on You. Today we're going to be taking a look at a very interesting watch. We're going to be looking at the Hamilton Frogman. Without further ado, let's drop down to the inspection area to take a look at this very interesting piece. Alright, so let's take a closer look at the Hamilton Frogman. Now right off the bat I'm going to give you the history of this watch. So, this watch was initially created for the U.S. Navy squad, the Frogmen, in the early 20th century, and this is kind of a remake of that watch. And it definitely has a lot more modern elements, but it also harkens back to the older piece, and you can see through the sort of retro Hamilton H on the dial and then on the crown there. I think that looks really, really cool. Hamilton had some very cool retro watches. Not in the early 20th century. They were more old style back then. But when you move more into the 60s and 70s, they had some really, really funky pieces. But that's just a little aside there. Now I'll get back to this watch. So as you can see, this watch's case is an absolutely massive 46 millimeters. And it is completely made out of titanium. Now this watch also comes in steel. But the bezel color is different. That's how you tell which version is which. So the blue, I think, is in steel. The red is always titanium. And then they also have other colors. Now I'm going to dive kind of into the dial itself there. As you can see, just kind of chunky numbers. And you also see sort of chunky numbers on the bezel itself. I know it doesn't really look like it, but on the camera, there is a loom pip at the 12 o'clock on the rotating bezel. And it is 120 clicks. It's a very, very solid feeling. Basically, everything about this watch is just solid feeling. And hearkening back to those military watches is the crown lock here. So you unscrew it like that. It's a bit like those U-boat watches that you see, which themselves were based on kind of old military watches that have this little kind of canteen-style crown. But one thing that I don't necessarily like about this watch is that for some reason, the piece of metal where the threads are on for this like screw-down cover are wider than the actual crown, so it's very difficult to set. You kind of have to use your fingernails, and it's a little bit difficult. That's one problem, but I think that's fine. And before I forget to mention it, if you guys want to learn more about this watch, I'll be leaving the link in the description, so definitely go ahead and check that out. But now I'll get into the movement of this piece. So this watch has an ETA-based movement, but it has an 80-hour power reserve, which is pretty unique. 80 hours is fantastic. It's well above my 48-hour threshold that I think is what most mechanical watches should have. This watch is definitely very capable as a dive watch. Obviously, as you saw, there was the 120 click bezel, and then there's also, it comes with a helium escape valve on the side there, and it has a water resistance rating of 1,000 meters or around 3,300 feet. And again, the construction is just absolutely tough. One thing that I think is actually very, very cool is that on the strap, it has kind of an anti-moisture coating. It's more like actually a fabric on part of the rubber strap. And the rubber strap itself is very thick, definitely very durable. I really like that. I think they did a great job with that. But I really think that kind of, it's the material that kind of wicks away moisture when it gets wet. It's used on the inside of some like open top cars. Like I think the BAC Mono has that, if you know about that sort of track base car. So now I'll move on to a wrist shot here. And as you can see, this watch is very big. I have about a 7-inch wrist and it looks still pretty huge on me. So unless you're a really, really big person, I don't think this would be the watch for you. Or if you're going to use it diving, I think it'd look probably fine over a dive suit. It'd certainly be legible with the size of that dial. But overall, I think it's actually a really good-looking watch. It's very high quality. It's on sale pre-owned here at J.B. Hudson for $750, which is around half the suggested retail price for a new one. And, I mean, the condition's great of this one, so definitely check it out. I really like this watch. If you like this video, please remember to subscribe and share. Thank you.